Hello everyone, hope you're having a great day. We've got a significant weather change coming up the next few days as an autumn-like storm system makes its way toward Northern California. For the next few minutes, I'll be discussing the origins of this storm, how rare it really is, what kind of precipitation numbers we'll be looking at, and the primary threats. My name is Tom Dang, a meteorologist with the National Weather Service in Sacramento, and this briefing was prepared on June 23, 2013. Let's start by taking a look at a satellite image across the Pacific Ocean. This particular image focuses specifically on the amount of moisture in the air. As you can see, there is a relatively narrow but very moist plume of air that has been tracking from west to east across the Pacific the last several days. As it turns out, this plume of moisture, called an atmospheric river, originates from a tropical storm that was in the western Pacific several days ago. It is very rare for moisture to track across the Pacific this time of year. In fact, considering the time of year and the amount of moisture being transported, we've calculated that this type of event only occurs once every 30 years or so. This map shows our precipitation forecast, with most of the rain expected on Monday and Tuesday. We expect much of the Sacramento Valley to receive between a quarter and three quarters of an inch of rain, although some areas may receive locally higher totals. The strongest precipitation will fall along the northern Sierra and parts of the coastal ranges, where locally greater than 3 inches of rain could fall. On the right, you'll see some of the precipitation records across parts of the interior. As you might have guessed, many places have relatively soft precipitation records this time of year, and a few select locations have never seen rainfall in their climate records on this date. Here's a list of potential impacts with this storm system. Since it hasn't rained in many locations in some time, oil accumulation on roadways will mix with rain to cause slicker than normal conditions. Travel delays, especially during commute hours, will be possible. Additionally, those that work in the construction and agricultural industries should be prepared to mitigate rain impacts, since those are particularly sensitive this time of year. Stream and river levels are low, so flooding is not a concern. Looking further into the future, a ridge of high pressure is expected to build back into California for the latter half of this week, with triple-digit heat possible in parts of the Central Valley by early next week. Check out these websites for our latest weather updates. Our homepage is www.weather.gov/Sacramento. Also interact with us on Facebook and Twitter at the shown URLs. We always appreciate weather reports and pictures. Thanks for tuning in, and be safe!